It's not honey anymore, bitch.
Okay.
It's not honey.
Wait. A trans woman decides to confront a black woman, and she, they, them, finds out. Like, it's absolutely ridiculous. We're seeing everywhere that if you, you know, breathe wrong, you're misidentifying my gender. You're hurting me. If you say this, if you do that, if you don't call me ma'am, if you don't call me sir, well, you must, you're a transphobe, and you're purposely doing this because you just hate trans people and you're just so concerned about me. It's like me, this narcissistic need to have everyone recognize you, everyone pay attention to you. And this is the thing, most people don't care what you're doing. Like they don't care. But if you see yourself as a victim, then you're always going to be a victim. No matter what anybody does, what anybody says, you're going to find a way to spin that narrative that they meant to do harm towards you. And this is the problem that we have today with so many identity politics. Everything is in some type of class or category or ranking of being a victim, a special victim. So essentially, what is a biological man can now attack a woman unchecked because he now identifies as a woman and wears a wig and everything. But you're going to see right here just how unhinged some people get. And we're talking about regular people who are not transgender are can act crazy. But we're talking about specifically when it comes to this, they see everything as a slight against who they've chosen to be and identify as. And if I'm going to have you canceled if you don't bow down to my tyranny and agree with me. And even if you did nothing wrong, I'll find a way to spin that you did something wrong.
Ran into me because you're a transphobe and you're having a bad life.
I have trans friends.
So why did you walk into me like that?
You're looking for problems and you're purposely antagonizing me.
Am I?
So I'm going to give you a minute and then I'm going to call the cops. Because you was going in that direction and now you're following me to this location.
Because you,
and I'm
going to
stand here for
me,
1 minute.
You antagonized me.
What's your name?
You're a black woman calling a
what's
cops on a trans woman. And I just want...
Oh, you're a black woman calling the cops on a trans woman. Now using it, you're black. How are you calling the cops? You're supposed to be aligned with me. The audacity, the racism, to just inherently think because she's a black woman, she shouldn't call the cops when a biological man with a wig and what looks like prosthetic boobs. Like, did you see the little chest? It's like here and there and everywhere, and it's like a little nip poking and prodding. And this wig, definitely Party City. Like, but we're supposed to take this seriously. This is a woman, and I have to say that. And if this woman gets in my face as a woman, even though they're stronger and bigger and, you know, more muscular, if we get into something, what, like, as a woman, what recourse do I have? And now, because I'm a black woman, how dare you say anything? Black people should be silent because we're a monolith. We all just agree with this. Somehow media has portrayed that black civil rights, black issues, is now because they've hijacked black civil rights. They've making it all about everyone's civil rights. They've taken black civil rights, okay, real struggle, and say, well, we're aligned with you with that, when it is not even in the same ballpark, and it's disrespectful to black people to even think like this. But that shows the mentality. You're a black woman. How dare you? You should be bowing down and worshiping me and being quiet, you know, because we're on the same team. No, we're not.
What's your name?
I want you to think about that.
Okay.
You're a black woman calling a cops.
Go ahead.
On a trans woman.
Continue to walk.
And I want you to think about that.
We're at 37 seconds.
I'm going to pray for you.
I'm going to hang. I'm going to stop recording at 1 minute and I'm going to call the cops if you're still in my area. I haven't offended you in any way.
You hit me on the sidewalk with your body.
You're following me.
You hit me.
Honey.
It's not honey anymore, bitch. It's not honey. It's not honey.
Wait. Ooh. Ethan took off his wig with the broken teeth and everything. Hold on, we need a close up. Wait. I gotta see it.
Beanie.
You hit me.
Honey.
It's not honey anymore, bitch. It's not honey.
It's
car was found in bear country, ma'am.
Honey.
Amy.
You hit me.
Honey.
It's what? Not honey anymore, okay. Bitch.
Look at this! I am woman, hear me roar. I am woman, hear me roar. You can't even get mad anymore. This is absolute lunacy. This is mental illness. Not like you touch me with your body on a public sidewalk. Mind your business. It probably was an accident. But no, you did it because I'm trans and you're a black woman and you shouldn't call the cops. Then I'm going to, this thing is praying for somebody. Who are you praying to? Beelzebub? Like, Rogaine for men? What are you doing? And it ripped off the wig, first of all, with these teeth.
Not
in
now.
The name of Jesus. Okay, let's get back to it. Because I am, wow. Wow! Wow. It's the clown world we live in.
It's not honey. Okay. It's not honey, bitch.
We're just going to patiently wait for the cops.
Yes, we are.
This is getting...
You're a hypocrite.
It's
you're
getting
a liberal hypocrite.
More aggressive.
And you're a bitch. Yeah, I am aggressive. I'm PTSD, bitch.
Okay.
You fucked with the wrong tranny today, bitch.
I apologize. I'm
sorry. That's what you should be doing. You should be deleting that fucking video.
I will not. Because I feel...
I have a lawyer. I have 2 and 3 okay. lawyers, honey. I will sue your pants off,
I'm not
going to
speak
bitch.
Anymore.
You got 2 or 3 lawyers, but you can't get your teeth... Through the wind... Do you see the aggression? You see the mental illness come out?
Yeah.
As soon as, like, this woman did nothing, but this is what she deserves. And I, you know, God bless the woman filming. She's actually staying calm and doing the right thing. Because this is an aggressive man trying to attack a woman for just existing. And he has PTSD. Sorry. They, I don't even know. Because took off the wig. Are you still a trans woman? I don't understand. I don't know. Like, this is...
I will sue your pants off.
I'm not speaking anymore.
Good. I risk my life every day getting ready in the morning, and you have the temerity to hit me with your body.
I don't know if you guys noticed, but my hands are shaking because I have anxiety currently because of this individual is not leaving me alone.
You need to go. You need therapy. And you know what? You'd be better off in the hood because the hood people, they know how to act.
Okay.
They know how we treat each other. You went. You went to Bard. You have a master's, you have an MBA.
I am currently starting to shake more because this individual would not leave me alone.
Fuck you! I have PTSD from being assaulted by people like you. And by that,
So the hood, it stands up for you? The hood is real people? Look at the racism. She must be for the hood, must be a liberal. Why aren't you acting like you're from the hood and just accepting my craziness? Where in the hood are there all these trans women walking around and people are just celebrating them? What? The delusion, the entitlement is what is throwing me. It is absolutely hilarious. Like, I wish I could be upset, but it is deranged. But this is what you see. Like, this type of attitude is what is being pushed on everyone to accept. And if you don't, well, I'm going to call the cops. I'm going to sue you. I'm going to do this, that, and the other. With these nasty Birkenstocks, this Party City wig, broken teeth, but you got all these lawyers on deck. And it takes a lot of courage every day to walk out looking like this. I bet it does.
I mean, insecure assholes. I'm not a race people like you. And by that I mean insecure assholes. I'm not a racist. In case that's where you're gonna
racist trend.
Because this individual would not leave me alone.
Fuck you! I have PTSD from being assaulted by people like you. And by that I mean insecure assholes. I'm not a racist, in case that's where you're gonna...
Racist trans woman attacks me on sidewalk.
You assaulted me on the sidewalk, and then you called the cops
on me. I think I see
me.
Lights coming down.
Good. It's taking so long. I looked better than you, and you couldn't handle it, because you have internalized misogyny, internalized femphobia, internalized homophobia. You're an angry young lady. You're an angry young woman, and I really wish we could be friends. But that does not give you the right to hit me on the sidewalk, which is what you did. You assaulted me, ma'am. Yeah.
This may be the most unhinged thing I have seen of one of these crazies like this. And this is so apropos that there's some fried chicken in the background the whole time. But then, I mean, projecting. I'm not a racist. I'm not, this and that. And you have internalized misogyny, internalized homophobia, I'm actually very proud of this woman who stood her ground calmly, kept herself safe, did not engage with this man, because you threw that wig off, you're a man now. And as aggressive as this person was towards her for accidentally bumping him, because you're jealous and insecure about this, yes, this is what cis women, which are just women, are jealous of. We're insecure. Look at you. I just want to be you. Like, and she wants to be you, of course. And this black woman, how could a black woman do this to you? She should be on your side with your craziness and broken teeth. That shows you how much they think of somebody who's black, even though they try to act like they're aligned with black people. But okay, I digress. But everybody else is racist. Everyone else is racist, except for them. Okay.